Alright, welcome back guys, and welcome to the show, first time here. I'm Vision here with Blind Entertainment, bringing you guys another video. Today I'm going to be giving you guys my review of the latest episode of The 100, Season 5, Episode 5, Shifting Sands. Now if The 100 is something you're interested in, don't forget to subscribe down below and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any future reviews on The 100 moving forward. Now let's begin. So, first off with this episode, I'm going to say it's probably the weakest, in my opinion, of all five episodes. I think the only thing that really happened was Octavia and her group traveling for the desert, and Kane and Abby's storyline, and Murphy and Raven stuff. It all just, I don't know, something didn't gel right with this episode. It felt more like filler. And yes, we do need filler sometimes, and yes, it did expand on certain things, but it's just, I don't know, there were certain things that just came off as we didn't need it right now, and we could have used this time to expand other character storylines. And I like what we got with Octavia, and you pick up this episode with WannaCrew heading into the desert, and you got Clark and Bellamy trying to talk Octavia into going the route she's going, because from what Clark tells us, it's the quickest way, yet there's sandstorms, and the sandstorms are so bad, it's like razor blades cutting through you. So she tries to talk Octavia out of it, but she can't, and they end up traveling through the desert. And I don't know, there's stuff I like in this, and there's stuff I don't. I like the campfire scene with Octavia and Indra, where they talk about love is weakness, and how Indra loves her, and how Octavia would never say that to her, and she thinks that if you love someone, then that's weakness, because then that person could possibly hurt you. I like how they expanded on that mythology. I feel like we haven't gotten a lot of that in the past, so I like that. However, the one part of the campfire scenes I didn't like was between Bellamy and Clark, where they talk about who was the stronger survivor in the past 6 years between WannaCrew or Clark. And I feel like WannaCrew were the stronger survivors compared to Clark. Yes, being lonely is a hard thing to survive with, but Clark had Maddie, whereas these people were trapped in the bunker for 6 years, had to resort to cruel, horrible ways to survive. Like, that's a hard thing to go through. I feel like Bellamy's trying to comfort Clark in a way, but yet it didn't fit. I feel like the dialogue was off there, and they should have just said, like, you both had it rough, or something like that. Not telling Clark that she had it harder, because I feel like both of them equally had it as hard, and they shouldn't have just singled Clark out as having it a rougher time to survive the past 6 years. I think that was bad. But then you go on, and they camp out at in the desert for the night, and Miller and his men come back, running back after having come across some kind of something in the desert, and there's something in one of the guards' stomachs. And I'm going to be honest, when I saw this in the trailer, I thought this was stupid and weird, and I was curious to see where they went with it. And then what we got in this episode, where the worms come out of the guy's stomach, it just came off as a cheap imitation of Alien, and I hated that. I'm like, couldn't they come up with something more original? Like, I get it when shows want to pay homage to these movies and stuff like that, but it was so closely mirroring the movie, and it just came off as such a cheap, amateur kind of thing to do, that it just didn't add anything to the story. It felt like filler, and that's what I'm talking about. We didn't need the worms coming out of the guy's stomach. We didn't need that. We could have just had them camping out at the night, something going on. It didn't need to be that. I feel like they added that in to have like a big suspenseful, tension filled scenes where that guy is like dying and Octavia gets infected and Clark has to help her. It just was like, we didn't need it. We didn't need those scenes, and it just came off as cheap amateur copy of the Alien, and I just hated that. It just really rubbed me the wrong way and made me not like this episode a lot more. And then you got Bellamy and Clark kind of talking to Octavia, and Bellamy speaks out against WannaCrew, and Octavia decides to go through the desert on her own, and they end up hitting the sandstorm as it comes through, and her people shield Octavia in the sandstorm and die, and they end up having to retreat. And then you get these scenes where Octavia's after in the morning, and they're all sitting there, and you got Clark. I think I couldn't tell who she was healing. I think it's Gaia. I think Gaia's injured. I couldn't tell if that was Gaia or Indra, but let me know who it was if you know in the comment section down below. And Octavia decides to retreat, and I like these scenes here with Kara and her talking, and I really like what they did with Indra earlier, because you can kind of see through these scenes that Kara and Indra don't totally agree with Octavia's decisions right now, because Octavia is making decisions based on anger and revenge, And I like that how they took her character and took her down this path this season. Because, yes, I know a lot of people hate it, and I agree. It's kind of, it makes you not like Octavia, but we need that right now. Octavia, at the end of season 4, was on the verge of becoming this character who had no flaws. Making her take this storyline where she's making these decisions based on revenge and anger shows that she is a flawed character. You can't have your character be perfect. And season 4, Octavia was on the verge of being that perfect character who had no flaws. So I like what they did with her character this season. And I'm interested to see what goes on. I still have her on my death list. I think her and Bellamy are my two top picks. I will say this forever, that I feel like one of them or both should not just survive the series. I think one of them should die. For me, primarily it would be Bellamy, because I don't want the whole Clark thing happening. I don't agree with that. And that's not because I'm a Clexa fan, or it's just that I prefer them as friends in the end, or having Bellamy die. And if it was me, I'd pick Bellamy dying just to show the brutality of this world. Although it could be Octavia, that too, but I just would be more satisfied with Bellamy. But moving on, you got that, and then you got Echo and them reuniting with the rest of the group, and I really like those scenes. And I know a lot of fans are freaking out online saying, Clark's gonna finally realize her feelings for Bellamy. And it's like, no, I didn't see those scenes as Clark like seeing that and feeling like, oh, you're with the guy I like. No, that was more of my opinion of Clark looking at and seeing it as, oh, that happened. And now Octavia's was more realistic, in my opinion. She had exiled Echo at the end of the last season. Yeah, I still don't understand why she'd feel so much anger. Like, this is survival. This is the end of the world. Just because this one person was exiled doesn't mean you still have to hold on to this anger 6 years later. This is a strong survivor you're going to need against Dioza and her people. So don't go down that path, Octavia. I really hope they don't do that. But I'm very interested to see what goes on in the next episode with Echo. This is one issue I've had this season, because Echo's been severely underused, in my opinion. And they added her to the main cast. Unless they have stuff coming for this coming up episode and more episodes coming up, I feel like making her a main cast member was a mistake. Miller has had a bigger role this season than Echo, and he's been on longer than Echo. He should have been promoted before her actress, and I'm still bitter about that. I think Jared Joseph and Chelsea Reist should have been promoted to the main cast before Echo's actor. I can never pronounce her name right, but I'm very still upset about that, because I think that was a big mistake from the show. Unless Jared Joseph and Chelsea Reist couldn't film as main cast members, then I understand it, but still, I just don't understand it. And if Echo isn't in more episodes, I think she should have remained a reoccurring character. Because if she can't film as many scenes where she deserves to be a main cast member, then she shouldn't have been promoted. But that's my little tangent there. I'm interested to see what they do with the characters moving into the next episode. And what's going to go on between Bellamy, Echo, and Octavia. I don't care about Bellamy, Echo, and Clark. I think that's going to be resolved quickly. I think everybody making a big fuss over that is just kind of looking for stuff where it really isn't needed or shouldn't be. But I'm very interested to see what they do with these characters now that they're all reunited, and how it moves forward in the story against Dioza and her people in the next episode. Then you got Cain and Abby's story, and I like what went on there with their kind of little love story there, and Abby trying to help the prisoners diagnose what they have. And I feel like what we got, I love the new character, Vincent, or whatever his name is. The actor playing him is brilliant. He gives off that very good, creepy, scary vibe that we need from these prisoners. And I think he did a good job portraying that. And the only con I have with this story is they leave a lot of things still open-ended with in terms of the prisoner's illness. I feel like we should have gotten a little bit more with that. We know it's not cancer, but there's still open-ended questions that are not answered within the storyline, which kind of frustrates me. I feel like they're dragging out the prisoner storyline with the illness a little bit too long, and I hope it doesn't go on for that for a couple more episodes. I hope they give us some more answers, at least in the next episode. Give us something. I don't want to go on until like the mid-season finale and wait until have it be like this big reveal at the end of the episode. I don't want that. Give us it quickly and don't drag it out. But then you got Cain meeting up with Dioza and giving her kind of information about Octavia's group, because Dioza decides she's going to try to like make a deal and try to like make an alliance with Vorna Crew. And I think this scene between the two of them having tequila was probably one of the best scenes of the show, maybe entirely. It just was so cool. It just was so different, and I like what they did between the two of them and the little chat there. And then, like, with Kane and Dioza being two people who are from separate times talking, and got this great militaristic leader trying to talk and kind of figure things out and kind of working her stuff. And you got Kane, this kind of this guy of philosophy and smart leader, meeting up with Dioza. I really like that meeting. And I always love how they put Kane in this kind of set where he's kind of the adult kind of person going in between the kids and kind of setting up these alliances. He did it with Lexa back in season 2, and he's doing it now. I love when they do that, because it just, he's a good character to do that. Plus, you can't have the kids making all the decisions all the time. It just is not realistic, and I like what they do of his character. And I'm very interested to see what they do of him moving forward. I think he is probably one of the best characters on the show, and I don't think he's going to die. I think there's a possibility that Abby might, but I don't think he will, unless he, like, saves Abby's life. Still, I don't think, I feel like Abby and him shouldn't die right now, and they're having them die right now would be a wasted potential for them in the future. Last, we got Raven and Murphy's story, and you got the two of them being interrogated by Shaw and McCreary, and I really like these scenes. I think some of the good torture and interrogation scenes in this episode come from these scenes, and I like what they did with the two of them. My biggest con, though, is they go to kill Raven and then chicken out at the last minute, just probably due to the fact that it's too early in the season. I hope one of these characters does die, and you got Shaw taking over interrogation and coming up with a plan with Raven, and you find out he's the one who kind of locked the missiles, which, looking back, was a cheap reveal and pretty obvious when you think about it. And then you got the two of them coming up with a plan, and then kind of you got Shaw double-crossing Raven after he lets Murphy go, and he reunites with them, but he soon finds out that they have a shock collar on him and that they're tracking him with it, and he decides to stay behind with Amori and risk his own life doing that. And I hope we get this, I'm guessing we're gonna get like this kind of redemption scene with him. I don't think we need it, but we probably will get it, and I'm interested to see what goes on. I think I'm still having both of these characters on my death watch for this season. I think both or one should die this season, just to give some more stakes to the characters in this season and show that the prisoners are a big deal and not like the original kind of villains we had on the show. But lastly, I just have one question for all you guys. Who would you follow in the world of the 100? What leader would you be the most likely to follow? Would it be Octavia, Kane, Clark, Bellamy? Which character would you want to follow? It doesn't have to be one I named, but just leave it in the comment section down below. I want to start a lively, good discussion with you guys if you follow me up until this point. So leave your thoughts and opinions on this episode in the comment section down below, and answer that question if you want to in the comment section down below as well. So yeah, guys, that's my review of The 100, Season 5, Episode 5, Shifting Sands. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up and share. And don't forget to subscribe down below and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any future videos on The 100 moving forward. This has been Vision here with Blind Entertainment, and I will see you next time.